I have the dynamic duo where I want them. On my side. Once I throw these switches and my mind machine takes over, they'll be known as the Crime Crusaders.
Hypnoanalysis offers the quickest method of probing the subconscious.
You will pay attention for a time, and soon your thoughts shall all be mine. Watch the pretty coin of gold, and you will do as you are told.
Batman, look!
It's some sort of mind ray, Robin. Clouding my mind. It's taking over my mind.
The transformation is complete.
What do you want us to do, sire?
Now just sit back and listen to the music as you concentrate and relax. You begin to feel every muscle of your body settling back in comfort and rest.
Now that I've got you right where I want you!
You are very sneaky. When I snap my fingers, you will sit your ass down and listen to this entire album. And don't you dare skip one fucking track.
It will be our pleasure to obey your commands, sire.
Excellent.
Jolts, Batman. What happened?
The computer override saved us in the nick of time, Robin. We'd better get back to the Hall of Justice quickly.
They should rename you the Dynamic Pickles.
Due to the graphic nature of this program, listener discretion is advised.
There's a vicious plant that looks so innocent, but its stem comes from the roots of hate. Marijuana, the devil's flower. If you use it, you'll be his slave. Marijuana, it brings you sorrow and may send you to your grave.
Youth is a time full of fun, of pranks and jokes, of ice cream cones and chocolate sodas. Youth is a time for getting a job, for finding one's place in the world. But sometimes, in these troubled days, the very thoughtlessness of youth has led to a living nightmare. Addiction to drugs.
These high school boys and girls are having a hop at the local soda fountain. Innocently, they dance. Innocent of a new and deadly menace lurking behind closed doors. Marijuana, the burning weed with its roots in hell. Smoking the soul-destroying reefer, they find a moment's pleasure, but at a terrible price. Debauchery, violence, murder, suicide, and the ultimate end of the marijuana addict. Hopeless insanity.
Little plant, you drink all this little water up so you can grow up to be a nice strong crime plant. Yes, and then you'll be smoked by all the rappers and make them do a whole lot of dumb shit that fuck up their careers. Yes, you will. Night night, baby.
An herb is a plant.
Herb is a plant. I mean, herbs are good for everything.
A tree that grows.
Perhaps the most controversial aspect of Rastafarianism is the use of marijuana as a central part of the philosophy. Officially named ganja, it's colloquially described by the Rastas as herb, and Bob Marley is said to smoke a pound a week.
Yes, raid! New bug killer discovery from Johnson's Wax. Raid hunts them down like radar. Sweeps bugs from the air. Attacks them as they crawl. And kills them dead. Outdoors, raid protects your garden too. A little kills insects that attack flowering plants, evergreens, vegetables.
Marijuana.
Caution. Ordinary household sprays kill plants. Raid saves plants. So don't buy several bug killers. Get Raid. Raid.
Marijuana.
Garden bug killer.
Hello, my name is Elliot Moore. Just wanted to talk in a very positive manner. Giving off good vibes. We're just here to use the bathroom. And we're just gonna leave. I hope that's okay. Plastic. I'm talking to a plastic plant. I'm still doing.
I didn't never said you could keep him.
What the hell are you doing waking me up so early?
Don't care to mind, he's gonna live in a car.
Julian?
Both of you guys, shut up!
Ricky won't give me my kitty.
Ricky, give him his cat!
It's my cat now.
I don't care! Give him his cat!
Oh. See that? You know why that plant's dead? Because a squirrel peed in it. That's why I need the cat. Protects my weed plants. Four plants left, guys. It's all I got left in my life. Please, let me have one cat to protect my plants.
Cat, stay in the car! Almost take your cat! Get out of here!
Stay
out
of this car right now.
Ricky, calm down!
Get the women out of here. I want that cat back. I need him.
Giving you sunshine. I've given you dirt.
No, not the bees.
You've given me
not
nothing but heartache and hurt. I'm begging you sweetly. I'm down on my knees. Oh, please grow for me.
We don't want no ants in our plants, does we?
Bang me! Mr. Sorrow, I was allergic until you raped me in that bathroom. I had no idea what I was missing. Thank you!
It's my pleasure, Marimo. I'm glad I was able to introduce you to the world of sex!
Oh, you're so fantastic! When you die, they should bronze your cock and put it on display in the National Museum or at least name a highway after you. Oh!
You're gonna give me a big head if you keep talking that way. Speaking of big heads, here's one right in your ass. Yeehaw! Ride 'em, cowboy! Oh, keep jiggling that ass, Marimo. You're much better than that mechanical bull down at the Western Bar in Yurayomi Street across from the fish noodle shop. You're my little bucking bronco, baby! And I'm gonna break you in! Oh, yes I am! Take it, girl! Take it all!
Later that very same year,
Billy Mays here to share with you access to illegal drugs without any prescriptions. Introducing the Big City Drug Station, the fast and easy way to get your fix loaded with my favorite mushrooms, cocaine, weed, ecstasy, and heroin. You get it all. And here's the best part. We'll send you drugs whenever you need them, free for life. Yes, that's right. Billy Mays can hook you up with illegal drugs. I use them, and they work.
Now, in the language the addicts use among themselves, marijuana is referred to as Mary Jane, pot, weed, or tea. They never say to each other, let's smoke a marijuana cigarette. They say, let's turn on, or let's blast the joint.
Marijuana is usually inhaled from a kind of cigarette.
Talk it out, man.
Wow! I've been
Marijuana changes behavior by briefly stimulating.
We are in the middle of a movement here.
And then depressing activity.
What are you doing in my swamp?
It can also change behavior by creating mild hallucinations.
I like you. No more.
Bite my shiny metal ass.
I smoke weed.
You surprise me to how shit you are.
Different people taking marijuana may see different things. Assistant one might have this reaction.
Smoke weed.
What do you want?
Whereas marijuana might cause Assistant 2 to see this.
Now, our feature presentation.
Tonight's program has been brought to you by
Batman.
In the middle of the 20th century in the United States of America, hundreds and hundreds of teenage boys and girls are becoming hopeless dope addicts every year. It's fantastic, it's unbelievable, and it's terrible, but it's true. Some say the Reds are promoting dope traffic in the United States to undermine national morale. They did it in China a few years back. It's certainly true that the increased use of narcotics plays right into their hands. But there's one sure thing. Nobody is going to stay an occasional user very long. This is one game nobody beats. If you use narcotics, before long you'll have the habit, about the hardest in the world to break. And the dope addicts say, you're hooked. Well, how does one become hooked? The simplest way to answer that is to talk to someone who has had the experience.
I guess I knew about reefer. That's marijuana. Ever since junior high. My girlfriend Ann and I went around with Jim and Bob. They both smoked pot. That's jive talk for marijuana. And after a while, Ann and I got so that we did too.
Excellent choice.
It's funny what it does to you. Everything speeds up to 100 miles an hour.
What a load of old shit!
So I tried it. But I was going to be smart. Just take it or leave it. Nothing was going to happen to me. But before I knew it, I was hooked.
Well, that's Phyllis's story. In the United States of America, 20th century. Unbelievable, isn't it, that such things can happen? Phyllis's case is typical. Most teenagers start off with marijuana. Then they decide to see if heroin has any kick. It does. Sometimes it only takes a few days to find out they can't leave it alone. In order to get money to buy it, they turn to crime. And that's the story. There are practically no happy endings when you fool with drugs. Doctors say restoring an addict to normal life is about the toughest thing in medicine. Well, what's the answer? Enforcement? Yes, that's one of them, certainly. Leave narcotics absolutely alone. Remember what happened to Phyllis and others like her.
I've learned my lesson. I'm never, ever, ever gonna smoke weed again.
Psych!
Oh, look! Oh! Ouch!
What do you think you're doing?
We've been walking a long ways and I was hungry and... Did you say something?
She was hungry! Well, how would you like to have someone come along and pick something off of you?
Oh, dear. I keep forgetting I'm not in Kansas.
I can see the witch was horny. The night was dark and stormy. There's no way I can up and run away.
Run away?
Then she showed me her green tits. What could I say? They look really good. Gave me some wood and our date was underway. I'll admit I stopped resisting when she stroked my cock like a piston. She wanted to deep throat me all the way.
All the way?
Then she sucked me and she banged me till I came. There's no turning back. I hit that crack and she disappeared in a flame. I can see she is no friend of mine. Face is kinda rough, I'll fuck her from behind. She scares the shit out of me for real. Hey, look, my cock's hard as steel.
It's not that easy being green.
Gee, we ought to do something, Fred.
Okay. How's about taking a nap? I got a better idea.
You want to get high?
That's it!
It's stimulating, mind expanding.
safer to use than alcohol. It's the in thing, the hula hoop of the jet generation, and as much a part of growing up as smoking corn silk behind the back fence. Such are the myths concerning marijuana, myths that lull thousands of young people into experimenting with a noxious weed. Facts or otherwise, marijuana is an intoxicating, mind-muddling drug.
Now, what starts with down that Jersey?
Cannabis.
Marijuana flourishes through a wide range of relative humidity. During the first few weeks of growth, the plants are especially susceptible to a dry atmosphere. If this is a problem, loosely enclose the garden with aluminum foil, white sheet plastic, or other materials. This will trap some of the transpired moisture and raise the humidity in the garden.
We grow organic vegetables, and we also grow cannabis here.
The Floronic Man has green thumbs on both his hands. Sardonic, grand, back in the Chronic Van, has more hydroponic plants than Peter Pan's Merry Men band of Lost Boys from It Never Ever Gets Any Fucking Better Land. Goddamn. GCPD and fuck that man. Artists cram their Floronic fans with bland brands of hypnotics pen from industrial cans. It's a simple matter of supply and command. Brainwashed consumers keep their heads in the sand. They don't know who they are, what's next, or where they were from. The way they cut out their thumbs for Uncle Sam might as well be done. No, not stupid, merely muted. Or worse, voices diluted, minds filled with lies, polluted. Driven by the fear of getting booted, speak out and get persecuted, executed. Disconnect to gain respect, aspirations, a crude silhouette. Ignorant muses think they're geniuses, but they just don't get it. Woodrow's got more rhymes than strain variety, cut more clones than the drones of society, behaving with propriety. Blinded by ideologies, obeying piously, not quietly but silently, oblivious to the irony, their democracy interchangeable with a dynasty. Their so-called protectors engage in under-table bribery, oh how they tire me. Raise my crooked hemp finger defiantly. Like the Queen of Hearts, Batman screamed off with his head and punched clean from the next temp, so Floro was presumed dead. Knocked it off, but the man discovered cannabis and I grew herself back up. Meanwhile, Jason's living in exile, stoners getting profiled for their lifestyles, always on trial. Once was a misanthrope, stone cold cynic rather, now grower of dope, stoned and madder than the Hatter. Used to hate the human race, now say fuck em all, howling out with laughter. Crazy and angry hag, a nomad rude hag. Fuck the dryads. Yesterday I saw a frat lad undergrad named Brad Glad Glad, paying off a hooker, picking at the scabs. Our future commissioners and
that's...
You read the news, even fewer can tell it. Quick, hand me that bat shark repellent.
Hand me down the shark repellent bat spray!
Sit down and shut up, or so we're taught. Stand up and get shut down like the gunpowder plot. The 1% spectating, sipping tea from their yacht. A penny for your thoughts. Let's pretend I had one for every ignorant American. I'd be drowning in Benjamins, more money than I could spend. Politicians wearing plastic grins hand in hand with Wall Street businessmen running in infinite circles again and again. People scarred while they decide the best stocks to invest in. Presidential morticians. Politicians like crappy magicians, they lure us in with a sense of false hope, hat rabbits, keeping us wishing, using all the oldest tricks in the book. How long must they kill our profits while we stand aside and look? It only takes one wave of the magic wand and, poof, all your tax money is gone. Whose side are you on? You can subscribe to one of two systems, the government or prison, you pick one. Never mind, I prefer to be damned. Gotham City Police searched for years but still can't find the Floronic Man.
Up.
spongebong in a dormitory.
Spongebong hempants.
Disgusting and green and sticky as he.
Spongebong hempants.
Smoking the chronic is something you do.
Spongebong hempants.
Your thumb on the carbon, he'll smoke it with you.
Spongebong hempants. Spongebong hempants. Spongebong hempants. Spongebong hempants.
On fire.
Wait, smells good.
Well, you would know.
Ah, the sweet smell.
Wait.
Maybe you should slow down on the Malaysian fire brownies.
No way!
Give me a sponge, baby, Sandy.
Well, alrighty then. Let's get her done.
How do kids get hold of this stuff anyway?
There certainly wasn't any around when I was in high school.
Yeah, but there's a lot of it around now, especially around high schools.
What's wrong with the police? Is it against the law?
Oh, sure it is, Dad. But it's just like a lot of other things. The police grab one person for selling marijuana, the next day two others are selling it. There just aren't enough police to go around.
Look, we don't want to ever try marijuana.
No.
Of course not.
Well, just because you don't know anything about it, automatically it's got to be worse than drinking.
Just hold a minute, Bonnie. I think you're way out in left field somewhere. Look, I don't know anything about going over Niagara Falls in a barrel either. I know I'm not about to try it. Bonnie, has it hit you yet that your mother and Jim and I are breaking the law right now just by having this in the house?
Nobody knows it's here.
Does that make it any less illegal? You're not guilty until you're caught, is that it?
You better get that stuff out of here right away, Bonnie. But... it's not mine. Well, whose is it? It's
the Floronic Man.
You gotta get that stuff out of here right away, Bonnie. What do you want me to do with it?
We're getting baked now.
Listen for an explosive live sound. We'll be right back.
Messages.
The Adventures of Batman with Robin, Boy Wonder. Batman and Robin, dynamic duo against crime and corruption, whose real identities as millionaire philanthropist Bruce Wayne and his young ward Dick Grayson are known only to Alfred, the faithful butler. Ever alert, they respond swiftly to a signal from the police, and moments later, from the secret Batcave deep beneath Wayne Manor, they roar out to protect life, limb, and property as Batman and Robin, caped crime fighters. Batman and Robin, scourge of Gotham City's kooky criminals. The Joker, clown prince of crime. The Penguin, pudgy purveyor of perfidy. And the
Floronic Man.
Watch out, villains. Here come Batman and Robin.
Greetings, Bat fans. This is Batman.
And Robin, the Boy Wonder.
And me too, Batmite.
Welcoming you to the new adventures of Batman. Watch us wage our never-ending battle of good versus evil.
Ride with us as we chase the greatest array of villains the world has ever seen, proving that crime does not pay.
What a load of old shit!
Get set for thrills and action. Join me, Batman.
And me, Robin the Boy Wonder.
And Batgirl. And me too, Batmite.
In the super new adventures of Batman.
Back to the show.
Maybe a little education yourself. Learn to relax. You might even call me a sort of Santa Claus.
I could turn your life into a nice, big, beautiful sleigh ride.
Oh, here. Try one of mine. Go ahead. It won't hurt you.
No, Mark. Maybe for somebody else. But not for me.
What are you worried about? You're over 21. You got a mind of your own. I think you're the type that can take it or leave it.
Hey, fellas! Al's gonna join the club! Come on, we can't miss this!
That's a good girl!
Don't be a fool, Jordan! It's fun! You'll love it!
Well, maybe one puff won't hurt you.
Sure, you know I wouldn't scare you wrong.
more. Hey, give us some.
Hey, have fun.
Oh, I'm on a great big purple cloud, and it's real purple.
Hey, you look funny. You've got purple hair.
Let's go dance. Let's go.
machine.
What a load of old shit!
And that's the problem.
Liar!
Great Scott, right over the wall! The devil, he sprung himself!
Sprung? You can say that again.
Marty's story is like many of the others. It started with marijuana cigarettes. He was determined to be one of the gang if it killed him. And it almost did. Several weeks later, after smoking reefers, Marty's befogged brain hit on a clever way to open pop bottles. Later, Stan went to the hospital for swallowing broken glass. Marty badly cut the inside of his mouth, though he didn't even know it at the time. Before long, Marty was hooked.
As for Two-Face, his hideout is either the Twin Falls Motel or the old giant coin warehouse.
Hold on, chum. If we triangulate these two points on the map with my bat marker... We got a winner.
The panty pantry?
What? No. Really? Are you sure?
Yeah,
well, there isn't time to lose. To the strip club, Robin!
Sick, what have you guys been doing?
Oh, we just hung out all day,
ate a bunch of dirty burgers and smoked about a fucking pound of weed and played a bunch of video games.
Weed is tight. Weed is tight. That's awesome.
That's awesome.
I know you don't smoke weed. I know this. But I'm gonna get you high today. Cause it's Friday, you ain't got no job, and you ain't got shit to do.
This is good shit.
Hey, you know what we should do now?
Eat?
No. Eat.
Choice excellent, my friend.
Oh, hey, listen, try this. I told my weed guy to step it up and he gave me that.
What is this?
It's called Mind Rape. It's actually pretty mellow.
Doesn't sound very mellow.
Well, he only had three other batches. Gorilla Panic, They're Coming, and something called This Is Permanent. Come on, spark it up. There you go. You got it.
Good.
Nice. Good, huh? Good job.
Yeah.
Take pride in that.
Mother, motherfuck, mother, motherfuck, fuck, motherfuck, motherfuck, noise, noise, noise. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, noise, noise, noise. Smoking weed, doing coke, drinking beers. Rolling fatties, smoking blunts. Who smokes the blunts? We smoke the blunts. Rolling blunts and smoking weed.
Let me get a nickel bag.
$15, little man, put that shit in my hand. If that money doesn't show, then you owe me, oh.
Right, wrong, good, bad. Those are things for you to decide. Too many people have already decided for themselves and you whether grass is good or bad. What's most important is what you think. So without any preaching from this film, let's examine the facts and only the facts. There are too many false impressions and prejudices to do it any other way. You're the generation with the brain power and the opportunity to do more for the human needs of this world than any other generation in history. Let's hope that your teenage children don't have too much criticism about what you did or didn't do because you were on pot.
Marijuana,
there anyone out there who still isn't clear about what doing drugs does? Okay, last time, this is your brain. This is drugs. This is your brain on drugs. Any questions?
Just as the alcohol drinker who finds himself needing a drink more and more frequently is the warning sign of his dependency, so it is with the pothead. The more he needs the escape from reality or the pleasure of marijuana, the more he is becoming emotionally dependent, exactly as the square and unhip alcoholic adult does. Do two wrongs ever make one right? Blow as much grass as you like, and your body won't need it? Right. And that's the problem. Unlike alcohol, when you take too much at one time, you don't pass out. You more than likely run the risk of an unpredictable and unpleasant bummer. That's right. It's a fact, no one ever got cancer from pot. But it's also a fact that no one ever dropped out of school because they were hung up on tobacco. And no one who just finished smoking a cigarette ever forgot she was driving a car as she tripped out on the beauty of a back road nature trip. No cigarette pusher ever tried to turn you onto hard drugs or the needle.
I hope you girls don't mind if we take care of some housekeeping. Don't worry, we won't ask you to lift a finger.
Not the vacuum! Please, anything but that!
Power.
Didn't I tell you this would be fun?
You're my favorite teacher, Mr. Saru.
Look at you, wet already. A slut through and through. You can't help being perverted, it's in your juices. Your pussy juices.
Please stop! I can feel my clit being stretched.
My goodness, whoever knew cleaning could be so exciting. But now I think it's time to make a mess. This is a bottle of my homemade barbecue sauce, heavy on the Tabasco.
I don't understand. What are you going to do with that barbecue sauce?
What do you think, my little piece of chicken? Did I mention I use a lot of Tabasco in my sauce? Some people complain it's too hot. All you need is a cob of corn up your ass and you'd make a great plate of food.
What's wrong with you? Don't you understand? It burns! You're burning my pussy! Please let me take a shower!
Nag, nag, nag. You chicks are all the same.
To the Batmobile!
The Floronic Man. His body is entirely in marijuana. His big villainous scheme to take over Gotham was to flood the streets of stronger and cheaper pot.
Look at it this way, Robin. He's terrorized Gotham City, he's baffled the police department, and he's held us up to public ridicule.
Batman speaking.
You are a fucking piece of shit! You fucking pussy! I'll end you! You son of a bitch! I'm going to rape you! Fuck you! Fuck! Fucker!
Every time I plant a seed, he said, kill.
Okay, let's see. Toke as needed. Caution, objects may appear more edible than they actually are.
A friend to feed is a friend indeed.
Get your little ass over here and smoke the shit.
I want you to take the Frankenstein shit, the deer shit, the green monster, the bling, and the bling bling. And I want you to roll it all into one joint.
No one's ever been brave enough to try that.
One man is. Roll it.
Oh, this is so good.
Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby. Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves
some marijuana.
Listen, Wonka's got a new one today.
What is it?
Ooh, the only man.
This is called...
They call it Skywalker.
Right. Not better than the Blue Oyster, but you can't be. I can't handle better than
this
that.
This is like, if that Blue Oyster shit met that Afghan Kush I had, and they had a baby, and then meanwhile, that crazy Northern Light stuff I had, and the Super Red Espresso Snowflake met and had a baby, and by some miracle, those two babies met and fucked. This would be the shit that they burn.
Wow.
Yes.
This is the product of baby fucking.
Smell it.
Okay.
Smell it. Enjoy. Like God's vagina.
Oh.
What, do you want to bathe in it?
You want to live in here?
Yes. You
want to
pee it?
Oh my God. I just want to shove it up my nose and have that smell all day. That's amazing.
Shove it anywhere you like.
Beautiful.
Interesting blend.
Interesting bullshit. That's the bomb right there.
The bomb? The bomb.
How does he do it?
It's this thing like El Nino, this airflow that comes from Hawaii and Canada, and it gets the dirt, mixes it in with the weed in a very special way. It's actually very scientific. I won't go into it right now, but dopest dope I've ever smoked. Hands down, dopest dope I've ever smoked. This is it, man. This is what your grandchildren are going to be smoking. That future. Only 10 bones more for a quarter.
Okay. I'll take a quarter.
How is he doing?
My dear boy, do you ask a fish how it swims?
No.
Or a bird how it flies?
No.
No, sirree, you don't. They do it because they were born to do it. Just like Willy Wonka was born to be
a peddler.
And you look like you were born to be a
hopeless dope addict.
Who can take tomorrow, dip it in a dream? Separate the sorrow and collect up all the cream.
Floronic
Man.
Floronic Man.
The Floronic Man can, cause he mixes it with love and makes the world taste good. And the world tastes good, cause the
Floronic
Man thinks it should.
Jungle. I can hardly breathe. Listen, it sounds like the plants are breathing.
They're eating her. And then they're going to eat me. Oh my God!
Why are leaves growing out of your head?
Well, that's just a side effect.
Why was there green stuff coming out of your cut?
Well, that wasn't coming out of my cut. That was fluid that comes from the leaves. Now, I'm working on something, and it's very, very unusual. I'm trying to build a plant that is part
There you go, little plant.
Hey there, Bert. What you doing?
Oh, I'm just watering my
marijuana
plant, Ernie.
Uh-huh. And is that all you do to help it grow, Bert?
Well, I make sure it gets sunshine, if that's what you mean.
Oh, sure. Mm-hmm. Water and sunshine are good. But aren't you forgetting something, Bert?
Forgetting something?
Yes, this.
Drums?
That's right, Bert. Music, Bert.
Marijuana.
Plants need music to grow.
It's not for mortals like us to tamper with the laws of nature.
This is mad
science.
It's alive. It's alive. It's alive. It's alive. It's alive. It's alive.
And now for our lesson. Remember, this is wine to drink.
They may be drinkers, Robin, but they're also human beings.
Drink! Good, yeah, good. We are friends, you and I. Friends. Good, good. And now, for a smoke.
Let that be an object lesson in the dangers of tampering with the laws of Mother Nature.
Hi there! This is Farmer Ernie! I bet you're wondering, what's a city kid like me doing on a farm like this? Well, I'll tell you!
I'm growing marijuana in my yard.
Our job is finished.
I lingered over my toilet, admiring my enormous 3-foot-long, 9-inch thick cock.
I am.
Dangerous! Dangerous! Dangerous!
I am.
Dangerous! Dangerous! Dangerous!
Let's talk with marijuana, because I was saying to you, I've never smoked marijuana, so I'm curious about what it does for you. And you describe it as an old friend who has never betrayed you.
I think, you know, it calms me down.
You say about pot, my love affair with pot became a long-term marriage. It was by far the smoothest of all my marriages.
It's worked out so far.
So,
you know, the argument always against it was that it somehow leads to other kinds of addictions,
yeah,
whether it's cocaine or heroin.
I would be the first to say that's wrong, you know. I think it eliminates other addictions.
The reason I'm against the legalization of pot is because I've seen too many felonies. And I don't mean pot sales or growing pot like this guy.
The Floronic Man.
I mean people on pot that shoot each other, that strangle each other, drive under the influence, kill families, wipe out a whole family.
That's not what you typically equate with smoking a doobie.
All reports, this peddler isn't the ordinary run-of-the-mill. He moves in all circles, Beverly Hills and Bel Air to the nightclubs along the Strip, Hollywood and the Wilshire District, all the way down to Skid Row. I'm assigning you
Batman
and
Robin
in this case. You're going to work as a team. Now, I want this deal handled strictly on the hush side. No pickups, no arrests. We can pull in the users anytime. If we do it now, they may clam up. They talk, their supply is cut off. Our job is to find the main source of supply. Who sells it to the peddlers?
The Floronic Man.
How he rolls the stuff in and where he stores it.
Looks like our vacation is over. It was so nice and quiet in the community, too. Somebody had to go get greedy and start a big push on the stuff again.
Well, if we blow this deal, boys, all our vacations will be permanent.
Well, better get some sleep. This may be our last chance.
Boss Commissioner James Gordon
was right. Sleep? That was for babies. I went home, dug out my old school books, loaded up my pockets with nickels for the jukebox, and brushed up on my jive talk. Then I played a solo in that malt shop.
Hey, young America, we need to talk. You may think this is uncool, you may even think it is bogus, but I want to tell you about something that has everyone buzzing. Something that concerns mature boys and girls just like you. Something called grass. Not that grass. I'm talking about marijuana. Weed, grass, ganja, joint, doobie, doo, chronic, ace, lobo, loco, loveboat, bud, buddha, blunt, pot, pat, pin, chiba, 420, and hashish, or hash for short. No matter what you call it, no matter what hip street lib it's referred or referred to by, it all comes from the same stash. It's all marijuana. I know what you're thinking. What is marijuana? What makes marijuana so dangerous? Where can I get some marijuana? Well, brother, I'm not going to nickel and dime you. So what about grass? Let's start with the basics. Rolled in zigzags, or puffed from 7th period woodshop projects, the smoke from this plant causes a brief state of euphoria, immediately followed by permanent insanity. Long-term use of marijuana can lead to a psychological dependency. Soon, you'll be taking all sorts of measures to get your fix. People will start calling you names like Pothead or Smokey McBongwater. Losing all motivation, it's likely that you'll drop out of school, take a sudden liking to sitar music, and maybe even get felt up by a cop or two.
If you do drugs and you think you're cool, you need to come to Sunday school. Put those drugs in a garbage can. Stand up tall, you're a Christian man.
This is the city of
Gotham City,
one of the fastest growing communities in the United States today. A city that still reflects the charm and customs of its native past. A city of culture, of advanced liberal education that keeps abreast of each new generation. A city of progress and tremendous engineering accomplishments. But like any other city, it has its back alleys, its world of saints and sinners, and the half-world of dark shadows some of them dwell in. The darkest of these shadows is marijuana. In every large city, there are men like
Commissioner James Gordon,
chief of the narcotic division. His job is to combat and control this evil menace. His fight, a 24-hour one. His weapons, simple but effective, patience and intelligence. Every case history tells the same story, a story that's a tragic pattern of men and women's lives. Cause? Marijuana. This harmless-looking cigarette is cloaked in many innocent disguises. But light the match, inhale the smoke, and it becomes an invitation to your own murder. This killer and the man who sells it has no respect for anybody. His victims are any lost soul. It matters not to whom the soul belongs. It's a profitable game, and when boredom sets in, heroin, cocaine, opium is always the next step at higher prices, if you'll live that long. This man has no pride. To lay his hands on an extra dollar, he'll set this killer loose on anyone, even your kids who go to high school. You may even know him. His name is
the Floronic Man.
America is threatened by a new drug menace. Street corner vendors whose stock in trade is the deadly local weed marijuana pass it out in cigarette form. From ingeniously concealed containers, the reefers go to the waiting hands of deluded youngsters.
Marijuana, the dried leaves and flowers of the Indian hemp weed, is used in the form of a cigarette. Marijuana smoking, experts point out, can make a helpless addict of its victim within weeks, causing physical and moral ruin and death.
The truth is that every reefer is loaded with immorality and bestial perversion, brutality, murder, sex crimes, insanity or suicide.
Should you ever be confronted with the temptation of taking that first puff of a marijuana cigarette, don't do it.
Yes, it came from outer space to fill the world with terror, to bring you unforgettable suspense. What was it? Where did it come from?
Your stance on marijuana?
But here's my stance, and this is a really serious issue. We have more people in jail today than any other country on earth. You all know that? We have large numbers of lives that have been destroyed because of this war on drugs and because people, you know, were caught smoking marijuana and so forth. I think we have got to end the war on drugs.
Bring a lot of weed, man.
Inhale and enjoy.
But what's that funny smell? I hate to suggest this, but my guess would be marijuana, an unlawful substance used to experience artificial highs.
Yeah.
The good cop, bad cop routine?
Not exactly.
You wanted me. Here I am.
You tricked me. What do you want?
Information on
the Floronic Man.
There ain't that much to count. I mean, I only work for him, okay? Not with him.
It'll have to do. Now talk.
Okay. They're supposed to have their claws in every dirty deal in Gotham.
Here's how it works, slime ball. I have questions. And if you have answers, I'll leave you alone.
Wait! Stop! I'll tell you anything you want.
Information.
That loser? I wouldn't wipe my shoes on him.
About
the Floronic Man.
No way! I ain't no squealer. You get nothing out of me. You hear? Nothing!
We're not the police. You want help? I want a name. Who's your boss?
I can't say nothing. You'll tear me apart.
Oh, then you got a problem.
Oh, hey, come on! For pity's sake! It's
the Floronic Man.
And where do we find Mrs.
Floronic Man?
I can't spill it.
Forget it, Robin.
What?
I said forget it.
This guy's ready to sing.
Let it go. The police can take it from here. Go get the bag.
What?
Now.
Hey!
Oh, that scumbucket. It's you, me, 30 stories. You're gonna tell me exactly what I want to know. Now, who's behind this little enterprise?
I ain't saying nothing till I see my lawyer.
That's all you have on your friend?
The Floronic Man.
I told you all I know.
What more do you want? Get me down!
Just one more thing.
Get down!
You know something, Robs? Crime does pay.
But the police coming straight from the underground.
Could this mean curtains? Will the identities of our dynamic duo be revealed to the whole world? Is this the end of their career as crime fighters? Can they avert disaster? Answers tomorrow. Same bat time, same bat channel.
For my next trick, I'll make
one joint
disappear.
Thank you guys so much.
I'll be here all week.
The blues.
You're still here? It's over. Go home. Go.